Pittsburgh captain Sidney Crosby's team has scored 10 goals. He's been on the ice for all of them and spearheaded the comeback win in game one. Washington captain Alexander Ovechkin's been on the ice for 7 of his team's 11 and got the winner with brilliance in game 3 in Pittsburgh. These two guys have faced each other 68 times, and here comes one more, and it's tie-breaking game 5. Just moments away in old D.C. In the modern era, there has been no goal scorer in this sport like Alexander Ovechkin. And to have a chance like that. This one's forced around in front. Oh! No! It would not go as diving across was hoping, and then the recoil would not work for Sheahan.
You talk about a breakdown in coverage. That's Sheahan right there all alone, all sorts of time. Just can't tuck it past Holtby. Goes to the backhand, waits. Just got to get it up, but can't quite do it.
Schultz to give it across. Oleksiak bounced one off the boards, hoping that it would come to Sherry. It did not, but it's okay for the Penguins. Brassard, and then Oleksiak, he scores! It was tipped en route, but the Penguins have struck first in the game.
Derek Brassard has been very, very quiet throughout this series. We're waiting for him to contribute. And finally, you see him with a little jump here. Runs it up the wall, just dishes it off for Oleksiak, and you got Sherry in front with a screen. That's a big contribution from Brassard, and Oleksiak, just what the doctor ordered, a goal not from Crosby or Gensel.
Chandler Stephenson couldn't come up with that one, but on second effort can, and pushed it along to Oshie, and then Stephenson rushing on in. Oh, he stick-handled around behind the net to the side as Matt Murray was moving around the other way.
Botta gets caught here on the two-on-one. Stephenson actually breaks in all alone, makes a pretty good move, and just the skate of Murray keeps it out.
Compliments of Hornquist, and now it's back over to Kessel again. Let it on back to Schultz. Shoveled one up high on Hornby, or on Holtby, rather. Meanwhile, it's passed along to the outside and then held back.
Kessel back to Schultz, and look at this. One for Hornquist and one for Crosby. Braden Holtby coming up large with the trapper.
Hoping for a good bounce, which he did get to Oshie, but he's double-teamed there, though it comes back now to Carlson, walks it on. Carlson waits, fires, score!
As the Penguins are scrambling, got a lot of people in front of the net, and it's high to the glove side.
Yeah, John Carlson, he's lethal, high glove side. That's where he shoots at game 3. Same kind of situation in their big win in Pittsburgh. It was a power play goal. Look at him, his head is up. He knows where that puck is going. He just tees it high, lets it fly, and it's all tied up.
Five-man scrum. Pop to the back. Connelly, and he scores! Two goals in 33 seconds from one down to one ahead.
Good pressure by Verona deep in the zone. They're able to retrieve this puck and get it back, and there's one that Matt Murray would like back. Goes five hole, quite a distance, maybe a little redirection. It bounces through him, but he can't squeeze him. And Washington suddenly on top.
Battled for deep, Ovechkin able to send it off the short glass. Dumoulin kept it, got it to Malkin, trying to pull it away, does. Backhander fought off by Holtby, rebound, and there's going to be a penalty coming up here. A slash against the Caps.
Great play by Dumoulin to Malkin. He'll get it right here in the middle of the ice. Here's Dumoulin corrals it, and then Malkin does what he does best. He possesses it, gets a lot of attention, whips it to the front of the net. We got a scramble and a slash. And a very opportune power play. Right there, the tip by Hagelin, and Holtby yet again on top of it.
Kept alive by Schultz and dropped back in. Crosby trying to play it there, got it to Malkin, laid it on back to Schultz once more. Sends it across to Kessel, steps in, shot one, he scores! It is tied at 2.
Schultz takes his time and watch this rocket. This is what they've been waiting for at Pittsburgh. Bill Kessel snaps it. Maybe we won't see so much head shaking from Phil from now on. I don't know if that deflects off Crosby or not. Here you had a pretty good look
at it. It does. It goes off of Crosby's hand right there. But it's not a pushing motion by Crosby's hand. It definitely is a goal, but that's the release you're used to seeing from Phil Kessel.
Dropped it in deep, Malkin, back to Crosby once more. Crosby steps, gives it back to Schultz, across to Kessel. Kessel fed, tipped on goal, scramble for it there. They score! Out of the net now, scrambled, it it's Hornquist, and it's 3-2 Penguins.
And how about Kessel? He knew Niskanen was coming hard at him, so he recognizes his outlet. His outlet is Hornquist right there. Look how wide open he is, because they have to seal the weak side to Malkin. So Phil Kessel knows he's going to get pressured. He makes the right read. Throw it from where the pressure comes from. The pressure came from Niskanen. Puck ends up at the back of the net.
Here in period number two, the bouncer back to Schultz. Shoveled one. That had to be cleared away, and then brushed right back along, and right around in front of the net alone was Brassard, but that didn't work.
That last shift was dynamite for Pittsburgh. They seem to be in that zone for an eternity. Watch the near miss by Brassard. This fourth line, if you want to call it that, a fourth line, was dominant.
It comes back along for the handoff now for the protected play that goes back for a shot by Niskanen, and save. Rebound, they poke away, and it loose. Can't be poked home by Eller. A cluster of players in front in the last 25.
Digging away, and Eller comes in. If he just could add a little patience to take it wide, he might have had an open net.
So you always want to see what adjustments or what energy a team comes into a new period with. A pass ahead, Kuznetsov, scores!
Pittsburgh got a little sloppy here on the change and got spread out. And in alone comes Kuznetsov with a great pass from Vrana. Terrific play right there. Had to just be picture perfect with it, and was. Kuznetsov gets Murray to split and hits the five hole.
On the turning stick of Oshie, and then back on for Eller. Closed off there by Oleksiak. Malkin came barreling in, and he's able to step around behind, goes down. Puck taken back over by Eller and centered in front. Oh, and Oshie was there but couldn't handle it.
Watch this near miss. A little redirection. I think that Schultz has got a stick on it. And otherwise, Oshie's point blank with only Murray in front of him.
Shane has a Kessel gliding. Shane fed it around in front. Oh, what a great save made by Holmby on Dumoulin. Back ahead with it now comes Ovechkin moving on in. Ovechkin with a pass in front. Scores!
Drops it back, wide open net, and Vrana finishes it off. A little loose coverage in front, and the price is paid.
They were telling Ovechkin, forward. He knew it was a forward, Riley Shane. He takes him wide, and Vrana, with that speed we were alluding to earlier, puts it to the back of the net.
Then it is Malkin, giving it on back to Kessel. A long jam in front. Kessel has the puck stolen away. It's Oshie. Goal!
He knows how to find the back of the net. Tough break for Kessel. Big goal for Oshie.
Any scoring chance, just tackle the guy. Don't be afraid of taking a penalty at this stage.
Schultz, but then knocked loose, and here comes Eller with the net empty. Score!
Final nail in the coffin from Lars Eller. Took his time, took a few seconds off the clock. We're going back to Pittsburgh.
The Caps can clinch in Pittsburgh. Their fans know they are guaranteed at least another game here, whether it's a game 7 or whether it's in the next round.